So last class, we introduced the sine triangle PWM, and with the sine triangle PWM, how we control the output voltage that is proportional to our sine modulating wave for our converter. So one leg only we talked about that one. So what we learned from the previous class is we can control the output voltage variation, that is for a converter like this single leg. For the single leg, this is S1, this is S2. So we are measuring the voltage, pole voltage A with respect to the fictitious sender O. Then we found for a sinusoidal reference voltage comparing with high frequency triangle waveform for switch control, we found the output VA0 fundamental or VA0 average. VA0 average is proportional to the VMT, modulating wave. That is our reference wave. Okay. Now, we have not talked about the harmonics. Okay. Also, I told because of the high frequency triangle PWM, the next high amplitude harmonics will be around the carrier frequency side, carrier frequency, triangle frequency side. So, by going for high frequency triangle waveform, we can shift the high amplitude harmonic to the high frequency side. Correspondingly, the ripple current drawn from the source will be controlled. It is highly reduced. So, let us talk about the harmonics now. So, PWM. See, if you really do the Fourier series and try to find the harmonics, it will get into Bessel function, complicated function. So, let us take a simple thumb rule. This I have taken, as I told before, from a very famous textbook by Professor Ned Mohan. So, the harmonics, we will be talking about the harmonics now. So, the harmonics order, and this is amplitude of the harmonics n, and this is the frequency number n, harmonics number. Okay. The fundamental happens at the frequency Vm, some amplitude. So, this is the amplitude. This amplitude, we know it is in proportion to our reference phase amplitude. Here you will have the fundamental frequency. Now, harmonics will be for a sine triangle waveform will be the sum and difference of the carrier frequency and the modulating frequency. That means the harmonics order will be JFC plus or minus KFM. Okay. Now, from here, from this thumb rule, we can find out the harmonics, order of harmonics present in the sine triangle PWM. So, what we have to do for J even, we have to substitute K all odd values. Odd. When J is odd, we have to substitute even values for K. Okay. Let us take J is equal to 1, that is here I am like J is equal to 1, then K can have J is equal to 1 means that is odd, K can have all the values 0, 2, 4. Okay. So, let us say J is equal to 1, the next harmonics happens at, let us take K is equal to 0. So, will happen somewhere here FC. This is FC. Then you get the side bands. Here K is equal to 0. Then you have FC plus 2 and FC minus 2. Fc plus 2, Fc minus 2. Then again you will have with the decrease, as the harmonic order increases, the sidebands amplitude will also decrease. Fc plus 4, Fc minus 4. So this way it goes. Okay. Now let us take J is equal to 2. Then K will have values 1, 3, 5. Okay, here I have but Fc plus 2 Fm. Here Fc plus 4 Fm. Here also Fc minus 2 Fm, Fc plus 4 Fm, based on this equation. So you will get sum and difference of the carrier and the modulating frequency. Now let us take J is equal to 2, that is carrier frequency, 2 times the carrier frequency, and we will be taking its sidebands. Okay. Okay. Now at 2fc, when J is equal to 2, the 2fc will have sidebands at 2fc plus fm, 2fc minus fm. So if this is the point at 2fc, we will not have any harmonic at 2fc. From this relation, we will have at the sidebands of 2fc, at the sidebands of 2fc only we will have harmonics, that is here 2fc plus fm, here 2fc minus fm, then again here a sidebands, that is 2fc plus 3fm plus 3fm, and here this one 2fc minus 3fm. So this way harmonics, again we can give the value for J is equal to 3, we can find out, but as the harmonic order, that harmonic order increases, amplitude decreases. So we are more worried about the harmonics at fc and its sidebands, and the harmonics at 2 times the sidebands. Okay. And I told you before, the sine triangle PWM, this harmonics amplitudes, if we can, Fc we can shift it to high frequency side. What is the advantage? Its sidebands also will get shift to the high frequency side. Then the current drawn by due to the harmonics, because of the impedance L omega increases, the ripple current amplitude reduces, and the current drawn will be more close to the fundamental, that is nearly sinusoidal. So to shift Fc to the higher frequency side, we have to increase the carrier frequency. To shift Fc to high frequency side, we have to increase the frequency of triangle wave, the frequency of the triangle wave. So what is the disadvantage? If Fc increase, the number of switchings per fundamental cycle will increase. If Fc increases, the number of switchings, that is S1 on and then S1 off and S2 on, the number of switchings per fundamental cycle, is the modulating wave period, per fundamental cycle. cycle. Cycle will increase. So what will happen? The switching losses, because we are using hard switching, hard voltage, we have voltage and current, we are switching. So for any switch, even though we have assumed ideal condition here, the switch will have during a finite turn on and turn off time, during that process switching losses will be there. So switching losses will be more and the efficiency of the system will come down. So switching losses will increase. So what will happen? Efficiency of the converter will come down, decrease. Efficiency of the power converter will decrease. Will decrease. Efficiency of the converter will decrease. So we cannot resort to high frequency PW. So typically for high power applications, the switching frequency compared to fundamental, you have to limit between FC should be limit between 500 to 600 hertz, okay, less than 800 hertz. Okay. So here FC is not very far from the fundamental. So the switching losses will increase. So we cannot resort to high frequency PW. At the same time, we don't want high amplitude harmonic currents. The frequency spectrum, amplitude and the frequency for the system I have drawn previously. Here you have the harmonics amplitude and here you have the FM. Then you have the FC here. Then it's sidebands here. So FC, FM. So FC decreases. If it comes here, these sidebands become very close to the fundamental. So your low order harmonics, that is fifth, seventh, will get boosted up. FC is still further closer. These sidebands become lower than the fundamental frequency. So this is called subharmonics. Harmonics frequency less than the fundamental also will introduce, will come into the system. Harmonic current will increase. For if PW, if you draw motor drive application, torque pulsations will increase. So we don't want to resort to high frequency switching. At the same time, we want to eliminate or suppress these harmonics. How it is done in a front end AC to DC converter? See, in the previous case, if you see our original front end AC to DC converter, this is our Vin, then you have the inductor. So inductor will suppress the harmonic amplitudes. Then you have the switches, okay. These are the freewheeling diode. This side is pole A, this side is lug A or pole, okay. And you have the E0 here, okay. So this lump will be connected here and this side will go here, okay. So we have talked about one limb with respect to E0, E0 and our A. So power flow can be, according to the our converter AC, this power flow can from in the AC side to the DC side as well as DC side to the AC side. So we have analyzed the PWM with respect to the DC side, and we found out the a pole voltage waveform with respect to the fictitious sender term. Now, if we see here in our converter, there is one more leg is there. The B leg is also there. The net voltage, what we want across AB is equal to VAB is equal to, if you take the fundamental, the VA0, the average variation due to sine triangle VA0, VA0 minus VB0. Okay? This is the fundamental. So, VA0 minus VB0. So, what we want, the fundamental component of VA0 and VB0 should get added. At the same time, this switching of VA0 and VB0 are independent of each other. That means VA0 will also contain the harmonics at FC and its sidebands, and VB0 also contain the harmonics at FC and sidebands. So we have two degrees of freedom. That is, one is for phase leg, the leg A, other one is for the leg B. So VA0 and VB0 we can generate in such a way, fundamental, fundamental of VA0 and VB0 get added. And we can choose the PWM, sine triangle PWM, because we have 2 degrees of freedom, as I told, because A and B, because 2 legs. The second one, we can choose the sine triangle PWM, the phase shift between sine triangle. We can choose in such a way, the harmonics at FC and its sidebands, bands gets eliminated or get highly suppressed. Sidebands, the harmonics at FC and its sidebands are highly suppressed. Highly suppressed or eliminated. So what is the advantage? So AB we can control independently. We don't have to resort to high frequency PWM, so that the switching losses can be reduced. At the same time, we don't have to worry that FC is very close to FM, so low order harmonics get boosted up, because we can choose the PWM of A and B in such a way the harmonics and effects can be highly suppressed. How it can be done? So we are using sine triangle PWM. We are interested in is VAB. VAB is equal to VA0 minus VB0. And we are using sine triangle PWM, where the output fundamentally is proportional to sine. Okay? So we will be using sine triangle PWM such a way, the leg for A, we will use the VB, the fundamental amplitude or fundamental amplitude of VB0 and VS0 should be the same, but the phase angle of VB0, that means if the fundamental is V1 angle 0 here, here we want V1 angle 180 degree. So already VB0 fundamental is 180 degree phase shifted with respect to VS0 fundamental. When you subtract, both will get added. That means the output will get added. Because of this already 180 degree, this fundamentals are in phase and get added. Fundamental get added. So how to get this 180 degree phase shift? See, let us draw the only switch schematic of A and B. Okay, this is A, this is B. Okay, this is S1, S2, this is S3, S4. Let us make it that way. So we will be using the same triangle, same sine wave, same sine. We will be using the same triangle for both the legs. Same triangle waveform. Same triangle, that is FC. Same triangle waveform for both the legs. Okay. So if you use same triangle, we will be using at the same time, same sine wave, that is a modulating wave. That is VMT. It is used for sine triangle PWM. See, if we use the same sine and same triangle, then VA0 fundamental and VB0 fundamental will be in phase. But we want VB0 fundamental should be phase shifted by 180 degree. So, to get the 180 degree, phase shift for the B, leg B. What we are, we will use the switching sequence, we will interchange. That means previously we said when sine greater than triangle, what we say, top switches on. That was the condition we used. Then when sine less than triangle, we will say the bottom switch. So, the bottom switch is on, it is assumed that we are switching off the top switch and switching on the bottom instantaneously, and we will assume the switching transitions are instantaneous. Now, this is for leg A. This is the condition. Now, to get the 180 degree phase shift, we will change the switching sequence for leg B. For the leg B, the conditions are different. For the leg B, say I will write it here, leg B, the condition. We are using the same sine wave, same modulating wave for both the cases. Sine greater than triangle, that is our carrier wave, VC, VCT. What we are doing here, according to this figure, not the top switch is on, S4. Bottom switch on. Then sine less than triangle, that comparison. We will do the top, that is S3 on. So the switching sequence is reversed. That will ensure that the VB1 is 180 degree phase. This will ensure that the VB0 fundamental it will have the same amplitude. We are using the sine triangle amplitude. The VB0 fundamental will be phase shifted by 180 degree with respect to VA0 fundamental, with respect to VA0 fundamental. Okay, that is this condition we want this condition. So what is advantage? When you subtract, this will get added. Okay. Fundamental VA zero, and we are more interested in the fundamental. So fundamental we can control by controlling the VMD. For both cases, so fundamental we can control it. Now, how about the harmonics? As I told, the harmonics at FC and its sidebands. We should suppress it, or the harmonics, individual harmonics from the A0 and VB0 should suppress, or it should be highly reduced. We have to suppress it or get it, we have to eliminate it, suppress or eliminate. Okay, if you see in the previous figure, the FC has the maximum amplitude. The center angle PWM, FC has the maximum amplitude. So, let us look at how FC can be cancelled. And if we can suppress the other side bands, that also it's okay. So, fundamental we should get added, and the how to get the fundamental it should get added, we know it. Now, how to get the harmonics? So, what we will choose FC here? FC. We will choose as 11 times FM. That is, FM is the frequency of the sine wave, the triangular frequency 11 times, that is odd multiple. See, there is a, why odd multiple? See, we want our output waveform proportional to our VMD, sinusoidal waveform, sinusoidal. Sinusoidal is an odd function. So, to get the odd symmetry, the triangle waveform also, the for the PWM waveform, odd symmetry means that upper half should be exactly symmetrical with respect to the lower half after 180 degree. Okay. So, to get that odd symmetry, we are using 11 times. Okay. So, this is typically used for, so the FM is for a 50 hertz mains or 60 hertz mains, 11 into 50. So, you are what? 55. So, that as I told before, the switching frequency less than 700 hertz is ensured here. So, 11 times we are using triangle waveform, and we are using the sine triangle. VA0, the sine triangle is like this. So, if it is the, this is our VMT, okay. VMT both, VMT is the same for both VA0 and VB0. So, triangle waveform, let us say this is the triangle waveform for the if this is the triangle waveform we are using for VCT for phase lag A, what we will use? We will use 180 degree phase shifted, degree 180 degree phase shifted, 180 degree phase shifted triangle wave, that is VCT for leg B. So, what is the advantage? See, this is the waveform. This is the waveform will be typically look like this. See, exact waveform, 180 degree phase shifted. So, this is the waveform for leg B, and this is the one for leg A. Now, what will happen to the harmonics? Because harmonics already, FCV said already it is 11 times FM. Okay. So the harmonic, the phase angle, the phase relation of FC, the phase relation of FC with respect to A and with respect to V will be 180 degree phase shifted. See this, how do you say 180 degree phase shifted? Because the triangle waveform is 180 degree phase shifted, and it is an old multiple. Okay. So if you see the comparison here, what is happening for phase A during this period? This is what is happening. Phase A during this period will appear for phase B, the final PWM waveform, it will here. So phase, if the phase A here will be exactly matching to phase B here because of the 180 degree phase shift. So from the PWM waveform, we can say that the, because of the triangle, the harmonics at FC will also be 180 degree phase shifted. So 180 degree phase shifted here. So the phase angle of the carrier waveform FC, it's 180 degree phase shifted. Then for the phase B, there is one more phase shift 180 degree, because the logic is interchanged, not the top switch when sign is clear. So there is one more 180 degree. So carrier waveform, fundamental gets 180 degree waveform, the carrier waveform FC have a phase shift of 180 plus 180, 360. So the PWM, the FC, the phase angle of FC, FCAA will be equal to FC will also be, will be equal to in the same phase, because two times, one is triangle phase shifted. See, we'll show the simulation study of this one later, then we'll verify this one. Triangle phase shifted by 180 degree. And then one more, the sequence of operation is also changed because of the, that is not the soft B phase, not the top switch, bottom switch is on when sign is greater than the triangle. Because of the inversion of the sequence of operation, of the switch sequence, this will also introduce one more phase shift for the carrier frequency waveform. So carrier frequency for the A phase as well as B phase will be in phase. So what is the advantage here? If you see here, the fundamental component of leg A and leg B, fundamental component leg B and leg A and leg B have a phase shift of 180 degree with respect to each other. Then, but the harmonics at FC will not have any phase shift, or that means they are in the phase relation between the harmonics FC at VS or VBC will be in the same phase. The phase difference is zero. Will not have any phase difference. So when you take the VAB waveform, the harmonics of the VAB waveform, you will have the amplitude of the fundamental will be two times the fundamental component of the VS0, or so two times VS0 fundamental plus VS0 at FC. VAB is equal to VS0 minus VB0. So it will have fundamental will be there. VA0 at FC will be 0 because we are subtracting, because of the subtraction both FC have that the same phase, it will get cancelled. So FC will get cancelled, then what will happen to FC plus 2FM? See, FC is already an odd function, FC plus 2FM will also odd. So it will also will have the phase difference as closest to 180 degree. So suppose, okay, the for FC the phase difference will be exactly like this. For other one, if you can multiply by the number and see, it may be very close. Here it will come. So the net value will be highly suppressed, and already the sidebands amplitude are suppressed. So in the VAB waveform, again because of the subtraction opposite effect, with the small phase difference, it will get suppressed. This is true with FC plus 4FM also, because it has, that is also an odd function. So what is the final conclusion from this one, from this PWM waveform? We have fundamental with the two leg A and B. If you see here, this is VN and FN, will have high amplitude fundamental at FM, then all the sidebands here get cancelled. Then the next harmonics happens at 2FC plus FM and 2FC minus FM. So next harmonic amplitudes appearing in the current or voltage waveform will be at the sidebands of 2 times FC. So there the amplitude, as you go, the harmonic order increases, the amplitude gets reduced. So this way, properly choosing the 2 degrees of freedom, we can have a control of the harmonics. Now, so in that case, can we suppress this 2FC and 2FC plus FM and 2FC minus FM? See, one more thing I want to tell you here. See, if you see the harmonic spectrum, the VN and the FN. You have the fundamental at FM, then all the sidebands at FC, we got cancelled. Then we said you have the next harmonic set happens at 2FC plus FM and 2FC minus FM. Then the next harmonic set 3FC. This is also an odd function. So its sidebands also get suppressed. So all the harmonics at FC and its odd multiple and its sidebands get cancelled or get suppressed from this configuration. Then we have harmonics at the even multiple and its sidebands, at 2FC. So that means again from here, 4FC plus FM and 4FC minus FM. Then only we'll have. All other, here if you see, all these harmonics get cancelled, that is all these odd multiple and its sidebands. That means odd multiple and its sidebands get suppressed, highly suppressed, when we use this triangle frequency and odd multiple of sine wave, and at the same time the triangle waveform for B phase is 180 degree phase shifted with respect to the A leg, and the switching sequence, we are using same fundamental, but the switching sequence is has a 180 degree phase shift for the second phase. So that will make sure that the fundamental get added. And 180 degree phase shift along with the switching sequence 180 degree will see to it that odd multiple and all its sidebands have a phase difference, have zero phase difference. So when you subtract, both will get from the both legs get cancelled. Okay, then is there any way we can suppress or eliminate this part? Then we require one more degree of freedom. See, for that we should use a configuration like this. See, let us say these are used for high power applications. So you have single phase mains here. The configuration would be like this. Okay, this is the transformer. This is our main single phase. Then we'll have the one secondary here, another secondary here. Then you have the inductance here, that is L here. Then you have one converter here. Here to suppress the next harmonic, second harmonics at the sidebands of second FC, we will use one more converter in series and parallel configuration. So let us see how it can be done. I think this configuration originally done by Siemens for their traction drive applications, front end AC to DC convert. So here this front end mains will be around 25 kV line. Okay, this will go here. So we have two converters, both will be feeding to our output DC. That means this will also go here, this will come here, and from the other side, this will go here, and this will come here. So what we want, the harmonics we said suppressed. What do you mean by harmonics with respect to the first converter with harmonic suppress? The current drawn by the first converter, the harmonics at FC and its sidebands will get cancelled. That means the reflected current from the mains, that suppressed harmonics will be there. Now, through this converter and interaction between these two converter, if we can suppress the second and this sidebands, then that will, if the second harmonics produced by this converter and this converter has a 180 degree phase difference, then this will not reflect here. It will get cancelled here in the transformer 90 circuit. It will not reflect here, and the current drawn here will be as closest to a sinusoidal with small ripple. So mains will not get corrupted, and the mains will have, and we are controlling the closed loop control such that we are getting a unity power factor also. That is the best way to draw power from the mains. Now the question is, how do you suppress the harmonics current? We do not want the second harmonics because of this one more converter is added. The second harmonics and its sidebands we should not get reflected here the primary. So here what we are doing, the same principle, identical principle what we used for here, we will be using here as far as the sine triangle is concerned. Individual phase like here, this is AB, this is, let us say A1B1, this is A2B2. Same technique we will use, same modulating way we will use. As far as the B2 switching sequence is concerned compared to A2, that triangle will be 180 degree phase shifted, and the switching sequence will be reversed. But what we will do here, the triangle waveform this one to this one, second converter, that is converter 1, this is, we will say converter 1, this will say converter 2. The triangle waveform here we will say, the triangle waveform of converter 2 is phase shifted by 90 degree with respect to the converter 1. So what do you mean by 90 degree? We will draw the waveform slowly and then find out. What is the advantage? So both converters will have FC, we will have 2 FC plus fm and 2fc minus fm. See, 2fc plus fm, 2fc minus fm. Here also, this converter also have side bands at 2fc plus fm and 2fc minus fm. Okay. So 90 degree means what will happen? So it is 90 degree phase shifted with respect to the converter one. So what happens? The harmonics at 2 times the carrier frequency. The harmonics at 2fc will have 180 degree phase shift, because it is 90 degree phase shift triangle, so 2 into 90, phase shifted. The harmonics at 2fc will have 180 degree phase shifted. Harmonics at 2fc of converter 2. Converter 2 will phase shift at 180 with respect to converter 1. But so 180 degrees. So 2fc plus fm, that also very close to 180 degrees. That means, as I told, because if you do the harmonics, so it will be very close. Slight phase shift will be there, because it is not exactly 2fc, 2fc plus fm. But because fc is very high, so this 2fc plus fm also very close to 180 degree phase shift. Yes, 2fc at its sidebands will be 180 degree, very close to 180 degree phase shift as far as converter 1 and converter 2. And the flux due to this transformer 1 and transformer 2 will cancel here. That means it will not get reflected here. So the harmonics at sidebands of 2fc plus fm and 2fc minus fm at the sidebands will get highly suppressed here, but not at the 4fc. 4fc means again 4 into 90, 360 that are in phase. But if you see here, 4fc is very far away, so that will not have much effect. So the fundamental will be very close to a sinusoidal with harmonics due to the harmonic amplitude at 4fc and its sidebands. That means what it shows, all the harmonics at fc and sidebands, and 2fc and sidebands, 3fc and 3fc sidebands. So that means what it shows, because of this one, we can finally summarize now. So what are the advantages here? So we'll conclude. So we have two converters connected parallel to the load, and the sine triangle PWM we are using, and the triangle waveform we are properly phase shifting, and the sequence of operation with respect to one converter, the leg for A and B we are interchanging. So what happens? This conclusion, fundamental get added, and all harmonics harmonics at fc plus or minus fm, then 3fc plus or minus fm, okay, fm 3fm, all that bands, then fc plus 2fm and fc plus or minus 2fm. That is because when this is odd, this has to be even. Here 2fc minus fm, okay, plus or minus fm, and all other odd multiple of fm plus minus 2fc get cancelled, and current drawn from the mains, that is our single phase line, or from the mains, will be sinusoidal, close to a sinusoid with harmonic amplitudes, with harmonics at 4fc plus or minus fm. This very far away. Also with the control, that is closed loop control, we are also trying to get unity power factor. That means the fundamental current is in phase with the mains force, unity power factor also we are achieving. This is a standard ACT, very AC to DC converter, used for traction drive application. I think originally it is used by the Siemens for traction drive applications, where they used 11 times FM. FM is 50 hertz, 11 times FM used for the carrier frequency, and they suppressed and suppress all these harmonics. Now, a closed loop control of this one to get unity power factor, and how to formulate the closed loop control. Before coming to the closed loop control, how we design the C value and L value, we will study in the next class. Then once the design part is over, what are the basis for designing the L value and C, then for the closed loop control, how do you formulate the closed loop and how do you design the closed loop parameter in the subsequent classes. Thank you.